Good afternoon, guys. Kenny here, Brave the Wilds. So, as you can see, and you might be able to hear, it's raining just a little bit, but it was raining pretty good all day today. So I decided to come down and see just how the hut's doing. It's rained plenty of times since I built it, but I just like to get a close look at it and just see how waterproof we are. Sorry about the camera shaking, I'm walking down the trail. But as you can see, big problem that I have down here, considering it's so close to the creek, is all this standing water. If you ever get a lot of rain, you're going to have lots of pools of water. A big one that we get a lot is right here, next to the deck. And then we get a lot collecting up near the picnic table right here. We get some collecting right there if it gets bad. We'll always get some right near the fire pit, as you can see. And then there's usually a pretty bad mud puddle right here and over there by the range. So, one thing that I'm decided I'm going to do to help knock down on the mud problem is I'm not going to rake this out anymore. I might do the range just so it's a little bit easier to find ammo. But in terms of the rest of the place, I used to do it to help keep down the mosquitoes, and it seemed to be a little bit less humid here in the summertime, but it just gets too wet. So I'm going to go ahead and just not rake it out anymore, just to help solve that problem. But what I've done around the hut, and it's not the most glamorous thing, but it does help, is I've dug some trenches. And what I've attempted to do is I've attempted to put dirt right up to the top, bottom of the boards. I don't want to put it on the board per se, because it'll rot out on me, because these boards aren't pressure treated. But what I try to do is get a little bit of slope right here so it would slope down into the trenches that I've dug. And as you can see, we got a pool of water because we've got a real low water table, or a high water table here. But that way, instead of the water hitting right here and rolling up under into the hut, it rolls into these trenches. But as you can see, I did have to dig out for the door here. So we do have a little bit of standing water in front of the door. And I've got some ideas working in my mind to help fix that. This summer, I'm not going to do a whole lot of sleeping out here, mainly because of the mosquitoes. And I designed this mainly in mind for wintertime. So the summertime is going to be mainly improvements. So we'll see how that goes. I'm thinking about some kind of chimney situation. These concrete forms are going to get replaced this weekend. So I've just got some ideas in mind to help make this place a little bit better. For the areas that I really thought needed attention, I put a little bit of plastic. And then I put dirt on it because that way, if the water seeped through the dirt, it would just hit the plastic and run away instead of, because these were low spots, instead of running into the hut. Especially with this stump here, it complicated a few things the way the ground laid out, the grade. So I've been trying to fix that. And as you can see, we've got the same slope and trench situation through here and onto this side. Let's go ahead and walk around. Again, apologize for the shaking camera. But right here, I again have a little bit more plastic and some more dirt to help keep water from just kind of pouring in underneath and going into the hut on my side over here. And as you can see, the fireplace does get wet. Again, I'm thinking about ways to improve that. I really would like a chimney that goes up a lot higher. I'm going to have to do some changes to the roof, so that we would get a little bit more of a draft situation and we don't get smoke coming into the shelter on some random times. It'll like to come into the shelter and we'll have to rearrange the fire to stop that. But if I can't get the chimney situation working, then I'll probably just lay a piece of metal, some kind of a slant, whether it's like this or like that, so that way water can hit it and run off and the smoke can come up and come out. Not sure, still working on it. And then as you can see, we get some pools right here. So let's go ahead and go inside. That's the main thing to see, is how dry it is on the inside. You can definitely hear the raindrops hitting now. So let's go ahead and start right in front of the door. This is our main problem. Let me see if I can give you a better angle here. This is our main problem. You can see it really well here, the contrast between the dry dirt and the wet dirt. Mostly, the reason that this occurs is water will come in, and this is the low spot, so it'll like to come in and drain out through here, the moisture. Now, if I were to dump this fire out, which I do in the mornings, it also likes to run out that way. So I'm thinking about maybe making some kind of depression here to keep the water in, or just doing some kind of grade difference in the shelter to help change how the water comes out, so that way it doesn't kind of flood out the main area. But looking right here, the ground right here is pretty bone dry. And the main thing that matters is right here, up against these edges. And you know, I can go ahead and feel the ground. It's definitely a little damp, a little bit moist. You see it sticking to my hand a little bit. But it's not that bad considering how hard it's rained today. As you can see over there, we got a little bit of a spider web going. I have to knock that out. And back there, get a better camera angle. That plastic back there's really done a good job, just kept that place dry. Move on to another spot. You can see right here, this dirt is completely bone dry to the touch. Really nice and dry. And right here, again, we've got a little bit of inherent moisture, but not a whole lot. Not as much compared to over here. But I think you can tell the difference, the moisture between right here and right here. Big difference. Overall though, tarp does a fantastic job of shedding the rain. Never really had any problems with that. So all in all, I think the shelter's doing good in terms of keeping the water out. Considering the fact that I sleep on a cot or a hammock, if the ground's a little damp, that's no concern of mine. Heck, we can have a foot of water in here and I'd still sleep comfy. So, I think it's going good. I can definitely change the grade over here, now that I know, to go ahead and see if I can't slope it down into the trench a little bit better. So that's what it's all about, guys, just making improvements, seeing how this thing holds up in different weather conditions, and making improvements on it. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.